Hello students, how are you all? I hope you all are doing good. Children, as you all are aware that we had started our chapter 11 time and we have completed the conversion part of time. Today children, we are going to do our exercise 11.2 which we had started yesterday, addition of time. Yesterday we have done first five examples related to addition of money and first three questions from the exercise 11.2. So children, today we are going to do question number 4 from exercise 11.2. Let's find out how we have to do the addition, which already we have done, but today we will take few questions and understand how to do addition of years and days, years and month, months and week, days and week. All these respective unit we are going to see in today's addition of time. See children, whenever I'm saying that how much time or addition of time, I'll take one example from your day-to-day life. Let's say Anjali, a girl, took 30 minutes to complete its maths homework. 30 minutes. After that, she took 20 minutes to complete how much? That English homework. So she took 20 minutes to complete English homework. After that, she took again next 20 minutes to complete Hindi homework. And similarly, she took 30 minutes to complete EVS homework. If I will ask from you that girl Anjali took this much time to complete maths, English, Hindi and EVS work. See, if I'll ask from you that what is the total time she took to complete all its work, so what you will do? You will do the addition of this. So this will become 0, 3 plus 2, 5 plus 2, 7 plus 3, 10. Fine, 100 minutes. So out of this 100 minutes, you can take it 60 minutes to make 1 hour. You can take 60 minutes to make it 1 hour. 100 minus 60, what is left? 40 is left. So it means Anjali took 1 hour 40 minutes to complete her work. 1 hour 40 minutes. See what we have done. After doing addition, we have taken 60 minutes from the minutes part, and that 60 minute is equals to 1 hour. So that will become 1 hour 40 minutes. So this example I have taken from your day-to-day life. So now we'll do exercise 11.2 question number 4, because till question number 3 we have finished yesterday. So we'll start with question number 4. Now what is that question number 4? That is add 39 hours and 48 minutes. Sorry, 48 minutes and 25 hours . 29 minutes.
these are the two time duration which you have been given to do it, its addition. So what is the first step? You will make separate headings of hours and minutes. So we'll make it hours and then minutes. Now just below hours you are going to write this 39 hours and 48 minutes. After that plus 25 hours, 29 minutes. So now after arranging it into column, what is the next step? We are going to do the minutes part. We are going to add the minute part. 8 plus 9, that will become 17. 1 will be carry, 6 plus 7. Now out of 77, you can take it out 60 minutes to make 1 hour. Yes, we can take it out. So I'll subtract 60 minutes. Now this 60 minute will become 1 hour and it will be added in this hour. So here you have been left with 17 minutes and here 9 plus 1, 10 plus 5, 15, 6. So what is the answer here? What is the sum you will be getting? Sum will be 65 hours, 17 minutes. Now this is very important part, this one, that whatever total you are getting, out of that total how much minutes you will take it, or how for making hours and days, then how many hours you are going to take it, that is very important part of this addition of time. So children, what we have done in this 39 hours 48 minutes and 25 hours 29 minutes will be given to you. First of all, you are going to make two heads, hours and minutes. Hours and minutes. And hours you are going to write just below the hours, and minutes you are going to write just below the minutes. So here we'll write 39 hours 48 minutes, which is your first one. Then the second, 25 hours and 29 minutes. We'll do the total. We'll start doing total from the minutes part. Now 8 plus 9, that will become 17. 1 will be carry, 4 plus 2, 6 plus 1, 7. Here the total is 77. As I told you that if it is more than 60, we are going to take it out 60 from that. And that 60 minute will make 1 hour. So that will become 1 hour and it will be added on our side. That I have told you yesterday only. Again I am telling you that whenever you are doing addition of hour and minutes. So if the total is more than 60, let's say it will be 61. Then also you are going to take 60 from that 61. So 1 will be left here, 1 you are going to write down here. And that 60 minute, that will become 1 hour and it will be added in hours. It is not like that if it you are having more than 70 or more than 80. If you have more than 60, either you must be having 61, then also you are going to add 1 on this side. So the total will be this on our side, and here you will be left with 77 minus 60. You will be leaving 17 minutes and 1 hour will be added with hours. So here the sum is 65 hours 17 minutes. So what next we are going to do it? Next is a question number 5, in which you have to add hours, minutes and seconds. So in this question you will be able to understand that how we can do addition of hours and minutes, minutes and seconds. Or if you have been given with a question in which hours, minutes and seconds, all three will be given. So with this question number 5, you will be able to understand as many concepts of addition which we have done till now. So our total revision question will be this. In this question, you have been given with hours, minutes and seconds. So let's start that. Question number 5 is 3 hours 3 hours, question number 5, 3 hours, 40 minutes, 40 minutes, 37 seconds, and the other one is 5 hours, 5 hours, 26 minutes, and what else? 28 seconds. 28 seconds. So this is your question number 5. You have been given with hours, minutes, and seconds. Another one also, hours, minutes, and seconds. Now here in this question, you are supposed to do addition of hours, minutes, and seconds. So what you will do? In this question, you will make three heads. Hours, minutes, and the third one is seconds. Three heads you are going to make it. And in this, 3 hours, 40 minutes, and 37 seconds. Plus another one is 5 hours, 26 minutes, and 28 seconds. So that is the total you are supposed to do it. Now, in 1 minute we have 60 seconds. In 1 minute we have 60 seconds. So we will do the concept with that only. In 1 minute we have 60 seconds. It means if the seconds will be more than 60, then 1 minute will be added on minute sides. So let's do the total. 7 plus 8, 15, 1, 65. So the total is 65. Now out of 65, you are going to take 60, because 60 seconds will make 1 minute. So this 60 seconds will be taken by minute. So here you have been left with 0.5 seconds, and 1 minute will be added on this side. Now this will become 60 plus 1. 60 plus 1, that will become 7. And here 6. So 67. Now out of 67, 60 minute is going to take it by hours. And here you have been left with 0. 7 and 1 hour will be added. Now here 5 plus 3, 8 plus 1, 9. I am not going to erase this, because we will understand this question once again. What is the question? You have been given with hours, minutes, and seconds to do the addition. Fine. First of all, you are going to make 3 heads, hours, minutes, and seconds. After making 3 heads, you are going to arrange the numbers which have been given here, 3 hours, 40 minutes, and 37 seconds. That you will write out, 3 hours, 40 minutes, and 37 seconds. Next is 5 hours, 26 minutes, and 28 seconds. Now what next we will do it? First we will add this seconds part. 37 plus 28, what is the total? 65. Out of 65, you are going to take 60 seconds, which will make 1 minute, and that will be added on in the minutes column. So 65 minus 60, you will be left with 05 seconds, and this total we will do. Now this total, you can see the total is 67. So out of 67, you will take this 60 minutes, and that 60 minute will become 1 hour, and it will be added on this side. The total is 07. The total is, what is left? 7 minutes. And 1 will be added on hour side. So the total is 9 hours. So here the sum is 9 hours, 7 minutes, and 5 seconds. This will be your total. Means this will be your sum. 9 hours, 7 minutes, and 5 seconds. Now, children, if you will sitting with your book, you can find it out that sixth question is same as of this fifth one. In question number six also, it is given in hours, minutes and seconds. So, the addition is same as we have done in this question number five. Now, children, we will do question number seven, which is related to days and hours. How many hours are there in one day? So, the answer is 24 hours. So, there we are going to go with the concept of days and hours. And if hours is more than 24, then one day will be added on day column. So, we will do question number 7. Question number 6, you will do it yourself. Because that question number 6 is same as of question number 5. So, same question we will not take it because we have not many questions in this and problems we are going to take it in our online class. So, let's come to question number 7. 8 days, what is the question? 8 days, 19 hours. And what next? 5 days, 14 hours. 5 days, 14 hours. So this is your question number 7. What we will do? We will make two heads, days and hours. So let's make it days and hours. Now, 8 days, 19 hours plus 5 days, 14 hours. Now, we'll do the total of hours. 9 plus 4, 13. 13 plus 5, 16. 33. Now, what I have told you that if the total is more than 24, then what we are going to do? We will subtract 24 from this. And what will be left? We will be left with 9. And this 24 will be forming one day. And which will be added on day side. So what is the answer over here? The answer is 9 hours. And one day will be added on this side. So, here the total will be 9 hours and that one day will be added on this side, 8 plus 5, 13 plus 1, 14. So, here the sum is 14 days, 9 hours. So, what we have done in this question, we'll understand this question once again because till now we have done only the questions related to hours, minutes and seconds. This is the first question which is related to days and hours. Now, children, you all are aware that in one day we have 24 hours. And this only we are going to add in this question. One day is equals to 24 hours. That you all are aware. And that only we are going to use in this. How we are going to use it? Whatever total in hours we will get it, that will be... From that we will be subtracting 24 hours because that 24 hours will be forming one day and that will be added on day side. So what we will do here, the total was 33. So out of 33, if it is more than 24, let's say it will be 25, then also you are going to take one hour will be left and one day will be added in day. Fine. So here the 33 will be there. So, out of 33, we will take it out 24 because that 24 hours will make one day. 24 hours will make one day and it will be added on day column. So, what is left? You will be left with 9 hours. We will write it 9 hours and the sum will be here 14 days. Fine. So, this is your addition. We are going to follow this. One day is equals to 24 hours. So, if the hours column is more than 24, let's say it will be 26, then we'll keep 2 hours in hours column and 1 day will be added on day side. So children, next question number 8 is related to this only, days and hours again. So we'll do question number 8 and we'll understand this. I'm not going to erase it. We'll do question number 8, that is same as of this question. So what is question number 8? Question number 8 is 12 days 15 hours, 12 days 15 hours, and next is 26 days 13 hours. 13 hours. So we'll make 2 heads, days and hours. So this we are going to follow. In one day we have 24 hours. Whenever we have hours more than 24, then one day will be formed and that will be added on day side. So children, let's start it. 12 days 15 hours, next is 26 days and 13 hours. Do the total. 15 plus 13, that will become 28. So out of 28 you are going to take it how many hours? 24 hours, because 24 hours make one day. 24 hours make one day. So that will be added on day column, and here minus 24, you will be left with 4 hours. That we will write 4 hours, and here the total will be 9 and 3. What is the sum? Sum is 39 hours, 39 days, 4 hours. The total sum will be 39 days, 39 days, 4 hours. So in this question related to days and hours, you have to remember this. One day is formed by 24 hours. You will be adding that 24 hours whenever it is more than, like I have told you that if it is 25, then you are going to keep it one here, and 25 hours out of 25, 24 hours will become one day and that will be added on day side. So that is there. Now next question is related to years and months. So we'll understand that question number 9 also, how we will be forming years and months. Now here I am going to erase this relation. Okay. Now children, tell me, how many months make a year? That is very important. That I will write 1 year is equals to 12 months. Now why I have written this? It means whenever in month column you have more than 12, then that will become 1 year. And that will be added on year side. So let's start that question number 9. 15 years and 24 years, 8 months. This is your question. So first of all, we will make 2 column, years and months. So we'll make it years and months. Now what we will do? 15 years, 9 months plus 24 years, 8 months. 9 plus 8, what is the total? 9 plus 8, that will become 17. And what I have told you, that if it is more than 12, whether it will be 13, then in the month column you will be left with 1, and that 12 months is going to make 1 year, and that will be added on year side. So we'll do it that minus 12, that will become 1 year, and that will be added on year side. 17 minus 12, you will be left with 5 months. And here the total will be 5 plus 4, 9 plus 1, 10 and 4. So what is the sum? That is 40 years, 5 months. 40 years, 5 months. 40 years, 5 months. So that is your total. What we have done? In month column, if it is more than 12, because 1 year is formed by 12 months. So in the beginning only I have told you, if it is more than 12, then 1 year will be added on this side and that will become 5 months. So now children, next question that is related to number 10 question, that is related to years and months itself. That is 30 years, 5 months and 19 years, 11 months. So how the sum will be finding by using this only years and months. So we'll do that question also to understand this concept. What is question number 10? We'll do it. Question number 10. 30 years, 5 months. And what next? Next is 19 years, 11 months. 19 years, 11 months. So we'll add it 30 years and 5 months. We'll write this 5 months. Okay, fine. And then 19 years, 11 months. So what is the total over here? 11 plus 5, that will become 16. And what I have told you, if it is more than 12, then 1 year will be formed over there. So we'll subtract 12 and 4 will be remaining. We'll write here 4 and 1 year will be added in years. So what is the total over here? 5. So here answer is 50 years and 4 months. 50 years and 4 months. So that is your sum. Now question number 11, this was your question number 10. If I talk about question number 11, that is related to 9 months 12 days and 12 months 28 days. So in that question you are going to use this concept that 1 month is equals to 30 days. 1 month is equals to 30 days. It means when the days column, will be more than 30, then 1 month will be added on month side. Fine. So that is your question number 11. Now question number 12. Ronit stayed 3 years 8 months in Chennai and 4 years 9 months in Kolkata. How long did he stay in these two places? Now the question is, Ronit stayed 3 years 8 months in Chennai and 4 years 9 months in Kolkata. So the question is, how long did he stay in these two states or in these two places? Now here you have been given with two different time duration, that Ronit stayed this much time in Chennai and this much time in Kolkata. You have been find it out how long did he stays in these two places. So children, what you will do it in this question, you are going to add both the duration. So time spent in Chennai, time spent in Kolkata, total time spent on two places or on in these two places, that you will write, and then you are going to do addition of that. So children, with this we have completed our exercise 11.2, that is related to addition of time. Tomorrow we will start with subtraction of time. And till that time, you all will do practice of this exercise. And that's all for today, children. Have a good day.